Meet the original Prusa multi-material upgrade 2.0, our unique solution which lets you print with up to 5 filaments at once. How does it work? Well, let's take a look at it. There are 1, 2, 3 motors on the MMU body. One motor operates the idler and selects which bearing will engage the drive gear to push the filament. The second motor rotates all of the drive gears. At any given time, only one of them pushes the filament further, depending on the idler rotation. The third motor moves the selector. The selector aligns with the path of one of the 5 filaments, so that it can be sent to the extruder. This is F.I.N.D.A, a P.I.N.D.A probe used as a filament sensor. Its principle is mechanical, so it works great with filaments of all colors. F.I.N.D.A is used during each filament change to detect proper filament load and unload. And should something go wrong during the filament change, the integrated blade can cut the tip of the filament before trying to load it again. Unlike the multi-material upgrade version 1, there is only one main PTFE tube, and it's only used to load the filament into the extruder. Here the filament gets pushed by the Bontech gears, just like before the upgrade. So it is not a Bowden system. Printing any flexible filament with Bowden systems can be really challenging, and the overall accuracy is somewhat compromised due to a bit of a play inside the PTFE tube. On the other hand, with the MMU 2.0, you'll be able to easily print flex, PLA, PETG, ABS, and just about any filament that's printable with the standard Mark III. And of course, we still use just a single nozzle. That means that we have to somehow deal with the color transition after a filament change. The smart pipe tower is still the primary solution to that problem, but we have new and exciting ways to decrease the amount of wasted filament. One of them is the long-awaited wiping into infill. If enabled, as much of the wiping as possible will happen inside the object's infill, leaving the wipe tower often almost hollow. Alternatively, or even at the same time as wiping into infill, you can wipe into a separate object. The color of the wipe object will be obviously mixed, but that's often not a problem, especially with mechanical parts. When printing in the single mode, your prints will be just as perfect as before the upgrade. But you'll have access to a set of new features. Have your 5 most used filaments always loaded, and when you start a single color print, the printer will automatically ask you which filament it should use. And if you have a lot of almost empty spools, you can easily finish all of them. The filament sensor detects the end of the spool and automatically loads the next one. Soluble supports work great with the MMU 2.0. But because soluble filament is fairly expensive, it's even better to use just water-soluble support interface layers. Installation of the MMU is simple, and we added physical buttons to it for quick navigation and filament loading. G-code generation for the MMU is done with our own and constantly updated offline slicer. No need to send your data to the cloud. We still have more ideas and cool features that we are working on, and we will be adding them in future firmware updates. In the meantime, don't forget to share your MMU prints online, and happy printing!